Hi guys, I hope you are well. Welcome to my YouTube channel. If you're a returning subscriber, welcome back, cakes. And if it's the first time tuning in, you're most definitely welcome on this channel focused on fashion, skincare, and lifestyle. Today I have a foundation video. So I am trying to find another foundation or alternative that is as good as the Estee Lauder Double Wear Foundation. I've been using it for the last 5 years. I shared it on my vlog. So I decided to do just a young tester. Today I think I have a full day. Not I think, I know I have a full day. So I'm gonna try out this foundation and see how it goes. The name of the foundation that we're gonna try off is Clarence. This is a 24-hour wear, natural full coverage, transfer-proof, all skin types for body and face, lets the skin breathe. People who want to care for the environment, like plant-enriched, anti-pollution, skin hydration, and cares for the skin. So this foundation was 605 Rand, and this is the Everlasting Foundation by Clarence. So I'm gonna try off this foundation, and they say that it's a hydrating foundation. I don't know if I mentioned that. So this foundation I would recommend for a person who have hyperpigmentation like me. Remember that I still have like hyperpigmentation here because I have acne prone skin and my acne comes and goes, so it's that type of situation, right? So I wanted to get something that's very full coverage, and I actually got testers. I got testers just to check my correct shade. Let me check. So the testers that I got was Pecan. Pecan is actually the shade that I bought. And the other tester that I got was Sienna. So I'm gonna see which one goes. They have a warm undertone from where I'm saying. Yeah, I was not sure which one to take, because if you're buying foundation, make sure that you buy it, you get a tester so that you can try it on outside when you're at home, so that you can see how it treats you, because in the store there's a lot of lights as well, so that has another impact on how clear and how the foundation matches your skin. So the first shade that I'm gonna test with you guys is Sienna. I've already put on my primer, hydrating primer, and a pore minimizing primer. So my thing with foundation is that I honestly love I love a dark foundation because of my marks, and because of the whole highlight and contouring, I've seen that works much better. So that's why I'm gonna go in with Pecan. Let's see, I feel like Pecan is my shade. This one is very rich and warm. That's how I feel. This one is cool. This one is actually cool. So I know that I actually have like a cool undertone. So I think I'm gonna start off with Pecan and see how it treats me. So what I'm gonna use a foundation brush, but the one that has bristles, not this flat one. Let me see again. Guys, as you can see, this one, Pecan, is much more complimenting to my skin. I like this one. I feel like this one is too warm for my skin. Do you get what I'm saying? This one I think is more of a neutral shade. So I think I'm gonna go with Pecan today. So let me first start off with, I think I should start off with the side that I went in first with, so that I'm able to see. And I remember when I bought it, the sales consultant did actually say to me that this is a very buildable, this foundation is buildable. So I was actually impressed with that, because I don't want a foundation that's not buildable. Now the thing with me today is that I want to see how it wears with me having a mask the whole time. Guys, I haven't used a lot of product, but you can already see that it has covered my face. So let me go in with this is pecan. So I'm just gonna go in with just, okay, I feel like I went too much this time. I'm just gonna cover my forehead and here with excess product. Guys, if you really want full coverage in terms of foundation, use a brush, not a sponge, because a sponge does take product, especially liquid foundation. I've seen that a sponge kind of like works with cream, but with liquid foundation you lose a lot of product. So I'm just gonna blend my forehead. I do have a scar here, and as you can see, it's covered, and also have irritation from the the rash that I have. Guys, I actually love it, so let me just go in again. Guys, you know me, I like full coverage foundation. Like, I want my foundation to be full coverage. So I'm just gonna go in here where I have scarring. And here as well. And I feel like my forehead still needs product. Guys, I think I actually love how it sits on my skin. I love how natural it looks. I feel like it actually just soaks into my skin. I don't know, you tell me. I love it. I feel like it soaks, like, and it didn't dry up quickly. You saw that I started off with Sienna at the side, and I took a while, like something like 5 minutes, and then I applied pecan. You see how it goes? Just want to build it so that I'm able to actually enjoy my day and see the full review in terms of how it sits. So as you guys saw, that I went in 3 times, just dipping my brush, and I still have product here, so I did not use. I'm definitely gonna take this product back, because I don't want to make it too cakey. So I think I'm gonna work with this. So let me just go in with the blender just to fill it in. So this is what I mean. The blender does take a lot of product. So imagine if I started off with a blender. So let me do the rest of my face and I'll be back. Hi guys, I hope you well. Guys, so today I have a review. I spent the entire day wearing this foundation by Clarins, and I just wanted to see how it goes. So this is a hydrating matte foundation by Clarins, and it's full coverage. You did see a clip where I was trying it on, guys. This foundation, I was very skeptical about it, because it made my skin look so orange.
So I was just like, this is not gonna hold up. And the fact that what the consultant was also saying, what were you using before? And I told her that I was using Estée Lauder and I'm trying to find another brand. She was just so, nothing comes to the level that Estée Lauder is. So that confidence as well was just like, oh my goodness. But anyway, I wore it from 12:30 until, so now it's 8 o'clock, right? It's 8, let me see. Oh yeah, it's 8 o'clock in the evening and I look like this. I was wearing a mask today and this is the amount of product that transferred. I made sure that I wear a black mask so that you're able to see the product that transferred. You know, black and white will disappoint you and you're able to see what left your face. I lost a product here on my chin and I also here as well because I was wearing glasses. When I drive I can't see, and I was sweating on my way and I was like, oh my goodness, I need to cool down. And then here as well on the sides where the elastic was of the mask, I did, you can see traces of the elastic bands. And yeah, I love the fact that it's hydrating, it's not matte. It's true, I did hydrate my skin before and also use the hydrating primer just to prep my skin. A little goes a long way. It's not the first time that I used it. Where I sat down and you guys saw it, it was the first time when I used it and I freaked out. I was like, no way, this foundation is orange. But if you don't contour and highlight, I don't think it'll work for you. The sad thing about it is that there's no variety in terms of shades in South Africa. They even struggled with me. So imagine, the shade that I took was Pecan, and Pecan was too warm for my face. Pecan reminded me of cinnamon in at Double A Estée Lauder. The way it was so warm, it makes me look so warm. So I had to properly put on a powder as well just to make sure that everything blends in and I don't look too orange. And that orange also reminded me of NC45 by MAC. So yeah, but it did not oxidize. It actually carried me throughout the day, as you guys can see. I was wearing a mask for like 4 hours straight. And I think it's a foundation that you have to really take your time. When you buy it, also ask for a tester so that you can try it on like me, so that you really, really sure that this is the foundation that you'll take. Otherwise, mix with other foundation to make sure that you get your perfect shade. Yeah, so this is how it looks. I think it did carry me and I think I did not lose a lot of product. But it is transferable. As you can see, my nose also, I did lose a bit of product and I could not take the heat. The minute, if you guys saw me when, I don't sweat, right? But I was sweating today and I was like, oh my goodness, if I blend this foundation on my nose, it's going to rub off. So I just didn't, I waited for it to dry and then after that, I made sure that I blend a little where I lost product. But I think I love it. I love how it makes my skin feel. It's not dry. If you have dry skin, I think this foundation will work for you, but just make sure that you get the correct shade, guys. Yeah, so Clarins, please bring more shades here in South Africa. Create more shades for us black girls so that we can buy your brand, especially the ones that don't actually want to go for a super high matte look, because I feel like this foundation is matte but it's very hydrating. And they did say that Clarins is actually more focused on skincare and then beauty, so that's what I love about them. So yeah, I just wanted to close this review so that you guys can see me holding up the product and how it acted. And today I had quite eventful day. I had to run errands and I was kind of like busy, and I really wanted to see if it will work. So yeah, so this is Clarence. I'm 24-hour hydrating matte foundation, and it was 605 rand. So if you would like to try it, I would say try it. Just make sure that you get your correct shade, otherwise you're going to cry. 600 is not small money, guys. So do take care. Don't forget to subscribe. I hope you enjoyed this video. Mwah.